It has been 9 months since an Elm Grove police officer stayed in the path of an oncoming train trying to free a child from a minivan stuck on the tracks.
After the impact, John Krahn was deemed a hero. The little boy strapped in his car seat was just fine. Krahn was not. And new at 10, Joyce Garbasiak has the latest on his recovery.
Kathy Toya, Officer Krahn is an 18-year veteran of the force, and all he wants to do is get back to work. But it doesn't look like that's going to happen anytime soon. His injuries are too severe, his healing too slow.
For John Krahn, a walk in the pool is no walk in the park.
How was that?
Painful.
Painful.
Walking in water instead of on land means less pressure on his injured leg, but that doesn't mean it's easy.
I think he gets frustrated because he'd like to be much better off than he is right now.
It is difficult. I mean, it's been going on for so long that there are the days you wake up and it's like, when is this going to end? When am I going to feel like I used to feel?
The effects of a decision he made in a split second will be with him the rest of his life.
That officer's a hero, man. He's got my vote.
Krahn, a police officer, stayed in the path of an oncoming train as he tried to free a little boy whose minivan had become stuck on the tracks.
I remember the impact so vividly and getting thrown through the air and bouncing along the ground as I tried to stop myself. And I remember laying there on the ground thinking to myself, you know, am I dying now?
He wasn't, but life as he knew it changed.
Ready?
The buoyancy of the water allows me to walk easier without the assistance of crutches.
Physical therapy in the water and on land are now part of his weekly routine. In the accident, he broke his shoulder blade, his pelvis, four ribs, and his left leg, which still, almost 9 months later, hasn't healed. He says he's in too much pain and on too much medication to return to work.
And then I'm still not sleeping at night. I'm only sleeping 2-3 hours is a good night's sleep for me.
Why do you think that is?
Just the pain is so high when I'm laying there. I just cannot fall asleep.
What may help?
Good morning. How are you this morning?
Another surgery, his sixth since the accident.
Just keeping my fingers crossed everything goes the way it's supposed to. And hopefully this is the final one. And be the one that'll fix me.
Sorry.
His wife and parents offer reassurance, but the agony he's in takes its toll on them as well.
It's been extraordinarily hard, and there are good days and there are very bad days. It's just extremely hard.
He's just going through so much right now, and he just wants to get better, and he loves his job. He wants to go back to work and lead a normal life again. I mean,
we're gonna work on your left lower leg.
The goal is that will stimulate bone growth, help the leg heal, and relieve the pain that has been a constant since the accident. Despite the surgeries and the therapies and the loss of independence, Krahn says he wouldn't change a thing about what he did on that fateful day, helping to secure the safety of a child.
Well, I have to ask again, would you do it all over again?
Yeah, I would, because it was the right thing to do.
So, did this latest surgery work? It's too soon to know. Officer Krahn told me as they wait for the leg to heal, it's possible he may need yet another surgery. This one, Kathy, on his shoulder because of soft tissue damage. It just doesn't seem to end.
We'll check up on him, won't we? All right,
we
but
will.
The little boy, he was saved. But his dad was hurt.
He was hurt in that crash. And his attorney tells me the father, too, has not fully recovered. In fact, he said they will likely sue the railroad, Canadian Pacific Railway, for medical expenses. The attorney says the train's engineer went too fast, despite knowing the village would be crowded with people coming in to see the Memorial Day parade. That train hit at about 45 miles an hour. Now, in the meantime, because of his bravery, Officer Krahn has been nominated for recognition from the television show America's Most Wanted. Go to my story on our website, WISN.com. for a link to cast your vote for him. It would certainly lift his spirits.
I think it would.